The materials needed to solder your bullet connectors are bullet connectors, wire, a soldering iron with rosin core solder, wire strippers or a hobby knife, and a helping hands tool. The first thing you want to do is strip the ends of your wires. I'm using silicone wire, so a hobby knife is a bit easier than a wire stripper. Be sure to strip less than you would think you need. Too long will lead to exposed wire coming out of the back of the connector, and we don't want this. Keep the length around 4 millimeters to ensure it stays within the bullet connector. If you're using the plastic housings that come with the connectors, be sure to slip these over the correct wires before getting started. On the wire end of each connector is a little hole. When inserting the connector into the helping hands, be sure that that hole is facing forward. Insert the bullet into the back of the helping hands clip behind the tooth part. Heat up your soldering iron to about 90% of its maximum temperature. When it reaches that point, say in your best British accent, but this one goes to 11, and turn it the rest of the way up. When your soldering iron is hot, insert it into the hole and let it heat up for a couple seconds. Slowly lower your solder into the end of the connector until you feel it connect with the iron and begin to melt. Fill the little reservoir about two-thirds of the way with the molten solder. Then, without removing the soldering iron, quickly insert the wire into the solder. As you lower the wire, remove the soldering iron from the hole in one motion. Within a couple of seconds, the wire will be fixed in place. However, do not touch anything for at least a minute or so. The wire will be hot, the connector will be hot, and the clip of the helping hands will be especially hot, so give it enough time to cool down. Repeat this entire process with the other connector. When both sides have properly cooled down, you can slide your connectors over the two bullets. To get these connectors properly seated takes a bit of force. A good trick is to add an empty connector onto the ends of each and give it a good hearty push against the table. When you hear them click into place, you're all set. That's it for this no intro tutorial. I hope it worked out for you. If you like these tutorials, please hit subscribe at the bottom of this video and be sure to check out my latest robotics build, Chopper, from the Star Wars Rebels series. All right, see you later.